In this illustration, we'll discuss about the maximum elongation in a spring attached to two blocks. Here the figure shows two blocks of masses M1 and M2 attached to a spring and placed on a smooth ground. Here it is saying if two external forces act on the blocks as shown and at t equal to 0, find the maximum elongation of spring during motion of these blocks. Here we can analyze when the blocks will start moving. If we draw the free body diagram of M1, it will be experiencing kx toward right and F1 toward left. And let us assume this block starts moving toward right if F2 is greater than F1. So during motion, say its acceleration toward right is A1. However, initially it may move in some different way. And for block 2, it is experiencing F2 toward right and kx toward left, and say it is moving toward right with acceleration A2. So if we write equation of motions of blocks, here you can see for the two blocks we can write kx minus F1 is equals to M1 A1. And for the other, we can write F2 minus kx is equals to M2A2. From here, we can calculate the values of A1 and A2, and we can also calculate relative acceleration of M2 with respect to M1 is. Here, A of 2 with respect to 1, we can write as A2 minus A1. If we substitute the values here, A2 is given as F2 minus kx divided by M2 minus A1 is kx minus F1 divided by M1. And this can be given here as F2 by M2 plus F1 by M1 minus kx times 1 by M1 plus 1 by M2. Now this acceleration of 2 with respect to 1, due to which the spring is getting elongated here, because 2 is accelerating with respect to 1, which can be written as Vd by dx. Here V is the velocity of M2 with respect to M1, and the same is given by this M1 F2 plus M2 F1 upon M1 M2. Minus kx multiplied by m1 plus m2 upon m1 m2. Here we can further write vdv is equals to this whole term m1 f2 plus m2 f1 by m1 m2 dx minus m1 plus m2 by m1 m2 kx dx. Now we can integrate both of these sides with the limits from x 0 to lm and v from 0 to 0, because initially the block M2 was starting at rest with respect to M1 because it was also at rest. And later when the spring will be at maximum elongation and the final maximum length of the spring is lm, then we can see if lm is the maximum elongation of the spring and it is at its maximum length, M2 and M1 would be moving at equal speeds, because after maximum elongation, the spring start getting compressed. So in this situation, if maximum elongation is LM, again the relative speed of M2 with respect to M1 would be 0. So this can be written as 0 is equals to M1 F2 plus M2 F1 divided by M1 M2. And integration of dx would be x, and on substituting limit it gives us lm minus M1 plus M2 upon M1 M2. K is a constant. Integration of x will be x square by 2. So this will be lm square by 2. Here in this equation, 1 lm gets cancelled out and we get the value of lm, which is the maximum elongation. On simplifying, this will give us 2. 1k is also here, which I missed out. This 2 by k multiplied by m1 f2 plus m2 f1 divided by m1 plus m2. So this will be the final result of this problem.